Let our hearts not be hardened to those living on the margins. There is room at the table for everyone. This is where it all begins. This is how we gather in. There is room at the table for everyone.
And today, the topic is that first of the Advent candles. And if you look there, you'll see we have an Advent wreath with all the candles. If you get up close, you can see that the candles are all lettered, so we don't lose track of what they are. But today is hope, and so we work with that theme today. So as we gather, would you just take a moment to be quiet with me, to be still. To be still and know as we open in prayer. God of all goodness, give us the spirit of expectancy. We know that all things do work together for good. Everything that happens in our life has a purpose, which we see sooner and sometimes quite later. But we know it's there for us, and we are grateful, and so we can be expectant. We can be full of hope, as we'll discuss today, because we know that we are expressions of the divine. We are children of God, and we have everything we need in the legacy that's been given us for all of our needs and all of our desires. We are so grateful and so hopeful. We wait in expectancy for the next thing to happen, which adds to the good in our lives. So bless us as we join. I am grateful for everyone who has joined us here this morning. And so it is. Amen.
Well, good morning. My name is Donna. I'm your hostess this morning. And let's have an opening song. And you may stand if you're in person, or if you're online, if you want to stand. Let Your Love Unfold by Daniel Namod.
Child, you dreamed of flying to the sky. Now there's nothing stopping you but doubts inside your own mind. You know that you can be whatever you would like to be. Your time has finally come. The world is ready now to see you. Let your love unfold. Let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Yes, you have the power to make anything so. Only you and God know where you are really meant to go. Rest assured that all your dreams are born to come true. If you just find your strength inside, let it shine on through. Let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. But do you love yourself as you know you should do? You are a child of God, no wall you can't break. Just got to believe that your great destiny awaits. All your wildest dreams will turn into your certain fate. So let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, starting with you. Let your love unfold, let your love unfold. It will change the world, it will change the world. Starting with you. starting with you.
Starting with you. And we welcome you. We welcome you to Unity of Payson. We're glad you're here with us this morning. If you're here with us virtually, please put in the chat where you're coming in from. I know that we have Kay from Alabama. We have Marianne from Mesa. And we have Ed from some part of Arizona. I'm not really sure what part. What part, Ed?
I'm in Ajo, down by Oregon Pipe National Monument.
Ajo, Ajo. Thanks, Ed. So if you're here for the first or second time, either in person or virtually, we'd like to recognize you. If there's anyone new in person, please raise your hand and you'll receive a microphone to tell us where, how you found us. Please stay after the service briefly so Reverend Neal can greet you, whether you're in person or online. Also, please stay after the service today. We have a potluck. If you'd like to be informed of our weekly activities, we have a Monday e-newsletter. Please give us your email address. And you can leave that in the chat, or you can go to the contact page at unityofpayson.org and leave us a message. Again, we warmly welcome you. And from our Unity of Payson family, let's say together, we love you, we bless you, we welcome you. And that goes out to those who haven't found us yet. Okay, next we have gratitudes. We are grateful for those who support Unity of Payson with your time, your talent, and your treasure. We're grateful for all the events that continue to occur and for technology that allows us to meet hybrid, both virtually and in person. If you would like to share a gratitude this morning, please raise your hand. And if you're online, you can raise your hand and unmute to share and mute again when you're finished. Can we have a gallery view? I want to read the, from the chat. From Rick, wish I could be with you in person. Ah, so he's home, but he's home with a cold. So let us give Rick warm blessings for health and fast recovery. Yeah.
So I'm grateful that we...
Microphone? Speak into the red one really close.
I don't have much. Can you hear it?
Yes.
Oh, there we go. We have something new here in person at Unity of Payson. We have a virtual store, not a virtual store, but
a bookstore,
a
virtual bookstore.
So there are a number of things that have popped out. It just looks so good and feels so good, and it just fits with the season. I'm grateful for that, but I'm going to let somebody else be grateful. Thank you. Pam, coming up.
Last night I went to the concert at the high school, the Christmas concert for the Duker Ranch, and a lot of people brought food for the food bank. It was really wonderful. The concert was fantastic. We had we had Lisa Tan and Bacchanal. We had the bell choir from the Methodist Church. We had Cinnamon Twist and Friends, and we had a sing-along, and it was just a lot of fun. I'm grateful for that evening.
Thanks, Pam.
Who else? Do I see another hand in purple?
Anybody online want to share a gratitude?
Betty coming up.
Good morning, everybody. This is Betty.
Hi, Betty.
And I'm just grateful for this season. I like the winding down. I mean, even though Christmas can get kind of chaotic, in general, the energy of the winter season is to sort of pull within and take stock. And so I love that quietness of the season. So I'm grateful for that.
Thanks, Betty.
This is your last chance.
Okay. All right. So we're going to move on to Unity is grounded in meditation and affirmative prayer. And we're going to change the slide now. Yeah. Our chaplains are available to pray with you if you have a prayer request. You may email your request to Reverend Neal at neal.unityofpayson@gmail.com. And we will pray with you for 30 days, after which we will send your request to Silent Unity for another 30 days of 24/7 prayer vigil. We have a gratitude from Rick in the chat. Thankful we have the diversity of spiritual practice here. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, if you want personalized prayer support, please leave your contact information on your prayer request. In person, there's also a prayer box on the greeter table. Okay, let's see. If you'd like prayer support after service and you're in person, please tap a prayer chaplain on the shoulder. Prayer chaplains, please raise your hand in person. I am also a prayer chaplain. If you have a prayer request, you can leave it for me in the chat. Okay, back to Unity's theme. I saw that slide pop up. Thanks, Tom. Our theme for December is Advent. And let's say our affirmation together. I make way for hope, peace, joy, and love to emerge in my life. And so it is. Today's speaker is Reverend Neal Worthington, and the title of his talk is Being an Expectant Being. And now for a metaphysical moment. We're just moving right along quickly here with these slides. Today's daily word is hope and faith. My hope leads me to deepen in faith. As Advent season begins, I feel a quickening, a renewal deep within me as I embark upon the spiritual journey leading to Christmas. Over the year, I may have hoped for lasting peace, greater love, or abiding joy. But as I have grown spiritually, I have learned to look for those things within, to claim them as aspects of my divine identity. Once I do that, I will begin to see them manifest in my life, first within, then without. Faith is how I begin to bring my hopes to life. Like my other divine gifts, I always have faith. It's up to me to decide how to use it. When I choose to believe that peace will blanket the earth, love will heal our heart, and joy will bring harmony, I am using the power of my faith to bring those visions to vivid life. From John 1:5, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. So let's tap into the light within each of us and radiate that outward so that those around us can pick it up and radiate it. And now Reverend Neal will share the message with us. No, he won't. Not yet. We have a mission and a vision statement. You can stay there, Reverend Neal, though, and do this with us. This is the first Sunday of the month, so we have reserved repeating this mission and vision for the first Sunday of each month because we don't want it to get too rote. We want it to be fresh. So let's say our mission statement together. We are a welcoming and open-hearted community, inspiring each other to live in love, joy, and service. And our vision statement, we enrich our world through spirit-centered service, positive human connection, and stewardship of all creation. And now Reverend Neal will share the message with us. Thank you.
Christmas is a great time for stories, and we're on the brink of Christmas, the Christmas season anyway. And there's a story that has always touched me greatly. It's written by a great American author. It's decades old now, so you kind of have to update as you go along. But I want you to tell me, as soon as you recognize the story, either the author or the name of the story. And I think you may have heard it. So dig into your memory as I begin to talk about it. The story is about, of course, Christmas Eve. And the characters in the story are a young couple named Jim and Della. Anybody? No, not yet. Well, Jim and Della they had had some adverse circumstances in their lives. They, one, were living in a tough time, and Jim's job that once paid him $30 a week, his salary was reduced to $20 a week. They lived in a flat that was an $8 flat, furnished. And Della scrimped and saved and got the best bargain she could at the grocery store. And every time she could, she put one or two pennies aside to save because she loved Jim and she wanted to give him a Christmas gift. Well, the story is being recognized. We just haven't got to the name yet. Okay, we'll get there. So Jim equally loved Della, his wife. And both of them were expecting a great time at Christmas, even in the difficult circumstances, with the exception of money to buy gifts. And both wanted to buy a wonderful gift, but they held on to that expectation, and I'm going to tell you the rest of the story later, but I'll tell you what the story was. The story is by O. Henry, The Gift of the Magi. So it's a wonderful story, and we'll get to the end of it because it fits more at the end of this. So parenthetical, we'll go to an actual message here. So we are talking about Advent and hope. You'll notice the lit candle, hope, in our Advent wreath. And hope is all about expectancy, very positive expectancy. And I want to talk about hope today. And I base it on a reading of a Christian scripture that I like a whole lot, and I've paraphrased it a little bit. Comes from the book of Romans, chapter 5. Knowing that adverse circumstances produce endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us. Did you note those three things? Endurance, character, and hope. And that's what we're going to speak about today. When we live in hope, we become expectant beings. Yesterday at Saturday Soul Boost, Joyous Rainbow from Colorado was with us, and a few minutes after we got done, she emailed me a quote, which I had not remembered, and it's just so appropriate, from the poet Emily Dickinson. Just a couple of lines. "Hope is a thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without words and never stops at all." Beautiful lines from Emily Dickinson. But let's get to the first of those three things. Endurance. Endurance brings to mind, for me, the unity power that we call strength. Strength. Endurance. Perseverance. The ability to persist in all things. So let's unpack this power of strength. This endurance capability that we have. These are gifts to us. These are part of our legacy. They're integral to us. We're created with this and the at least the seed of it right inside of us, and we can work to see that seed flourish and grow. First thing about endurance is don't focus on it. Focus on the endurance, yes, but don't focus on the adversity. We all know that whatever we focus on, we tend to draw toward us. So when we look at tough times, think about endurance. Think about hope. Train your mind to switch when it wants to go the other way and come back to the truth that you know. That hope and living in hope will bring us all that we desire, even though we don't see it right in front of ourselves. Hope is also an antidote to fear, and it's shown in endurance. When you are able to endure a challenging situation, you grow out of a fearful milieu into one that has hope, that sees to the future. You grow out of looking at the past and all the horrible things that happened there, and you begin to look forward and look upward to hope. Because you remember that all things work together for good. Whatever the circumstances that you're enduring, it's all working together for good. It may take you a while to see that. Might not even happen in this lifetime. But we do know with eyes of faith that everything works together for good. Endurance sees beyond the appearances that are there. Oh, this is the one of the key things with our metaphysical understanding, that what we see in front of us is not reality. But the reality that we are created to live out is something that we look beyond the difficult circumstance to see. And I'm sure you've taken opportunity to use your inquisitiveness and your curiousness and your imagination to see that from time to time. If we're on the pathway to living out hope, we have to be able to see beyond the difficulty. And also to affirm that love that we are, love that is being given to us continually, brings miracles in our lives. I think sometimes we don't experience those miracles because we can't affirm enough the love that is there, and affirm that using that power of strength to endure whatever situation is with us at the moment, that allows us to pave the way to seeing of miracles. Miracles, according to the Course in Miracles, are a shift in perception. We look differently. We look beyond. We look up. Endurance. Endurance produces Character. Something we don't talk about very much. Character. But if we allow adversity to do so, it will produce in us character. The character will be one that knows that there is nothing to fear. All of our fears are transcended by the hope that leads eventually to the expression of love in our lives. So, when you think of character, that should be part of our spiritual practice. What we're developing, the character, to get to that place where we experience miracles as a very natural part of our being. Character does not focus on foibles and faults and flaws. It focuses on the possibilities that we have to become that divine expression extraordinaire. No flaws. Having or working on developing our character also allows us to tap into the wisdom that is innate within us. Again, expressions of the divine, children of God, within us is also that power of wisdom, the power to perceive accurately, to evaluate. Tapping into wisdom is one of the things that developing character. Another thing about character is that character makes choices. Ever been in a situation where you just didn't want to choose? You wanted to bail out and run. Well, character, as it's being developed, produced by the adversity, will allow us to make choices. And not only just choices, but choices that are positive. Choices that let us continue on the path, the spiritual path that we're on. Choices perhaps to avoid bad company or unhelpful company or company that just doesn't serve us. Oh, so difficult that is. To set boundaries sometimes, to say, you know, I'm going to limit the time I spend with somebody or limit the time I put myself in a certain situation because I'm on the path of developing character. And so I can choose, and I can choose that which is good, and I can kind of push aside that which doesn't serve me well, which doesn't get me going where I really want to go. Yes, character, when produced by adversity, engenders hope, and hope is the next thing. It emerges, of course, from those diverse adverse circumstances. And it's the process, this hope. I don't know if anybody remembers, we talked about the faith scale in the past. And we began on the lower end of that scale, and we talked about despair and doubt. And then eventually we got to the place of hope. Hope allows us to move from that despair, that doubt, that drags us down, and to move further up to trust, to faith, to belief, and even to divine knowing. Hope is so key because it's so human, but it's pointed to the divine. It's so very human, but pointed toward the divine. So we get on that faith track when we make the most out of hope in our lives. Miracles become expected. They're natural. They're a part of the reality of things as it is in our creation and our sustenance here in this life. Miracles are also a kind of exchange. And this points us toward something about hope. The exchange brings forth the love. We talk about exchange when we talk about giving and receiving, but that's demonstrated in many, many ways. So we get engaged in the exchange, the human-divine exchange. That's hope, and that's what brings us what we truly desire. The Christmas story, not the O. Henry Christmas story, but the traditional Christmas story, in that the nation, the Jewish people, were waiting for the hope that would deliver them from Roman dominance. And so the Messiah, which we identify as Jesus, arrived to bring that hope into reality. So there you go. Remember, endurance in adversity produces character. Don't miss that step. And character produces hope, and hope doesn't disappoint. Hope, when pointed in the right direction, never, never, never disappoints. So now we get to how do I do that? How do I get on this track going from endurance to character to hope? First thing, look beyond the circumstances. When something terrible is seeming to be right there, can you pause and look beyond? Look at the possibilities. Imagine how that unreal circumstances in your life may be different. It may be something that's really contributing to your good. I like the focus on hope, that positive, pointed to the divine hope. And I love a poem. Today is a poem day. I love the poem that Maya Angelou wrote, and I have reshuffled it a little bit so it kind of fits where we're at. Anybody remember the poem? It's also turned out to be a book, Caged Bird. I see some heads nodding. So here's what Maya Angelou writes. Begins with the caged bird. A caged bird stands on the grave of dreams. His shadow shouts on a nightmare scream. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. This caged bird sings with a fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still. A free bird, that's the one that's got hope. A free bird leaps on the back of the wind and floats downstream till the current ends and dips his wing in the orange sun rays and dares to claim the sky. The free bird thinks of another breeze and the trade winds soft through the sighing trees and the fat worms waiting on a dawn bright lawn, and he names the sky his own. Hope. Turning from that which brings us down to that which raises us up. So that first point, look beyond the situation. Secondly, affirm hope. We talk about affirmation all the time. Affirm hope, affirm hope, affirm hope. And then begin to move up that scale to trust and faith and beyond. Get that, put those post-it notes out, write those affirmations as they come to you. Put them up there. But I'm going to help you do that a little bit more time. Would you put up the slide? And Pam, would you hand out that little gift that we have? Debbie, I'm sorry. I'm looking right through. I'm looking beyond Debbie into Pam. Pam's looking around and saying, what? So here it is. I have made kitchen magnets for you. Expect the best. Being an expectant being, we have a choice. Expect the very best. When you find yourself expecting something otherwise, shut that down. Turn away from it and expect the very best. Now put this on your refrigerator and this will help you remind you. This is a very, very short affirmation. But as we met together on Saturday Soul Boost yesterday, Pam, you were there. No, Pam, you weren't there. You wanted to be there, but you couldn't be, he said. But I know that some of you were. And those, when they were feeding back to me, said, you know, hope isn't anything unless you do something, isn't any good unless you do something with it. Hope isn't hope unless you begin to move your feet. So how do I do that? Begin to move your feet. I think the book of James talks about faith, and hope is kind of a lower level of faith. Faith without works is dead. Well, hope without moving your feet is not going to get you very far. You know exactly how you are to be moving your feet. You have the knowledge within you. This is mine to do. Access that in the quiet. And begin to move your feet. I love, I have another quote here because I like it. It's true not only for you as an individual, but it's true for us as a community, as a nation, as a global society. The quote is by Barack Obama. And he says, we choose hope over fear. We see the future not as something out of our control, but as something we can shape for the better through concerted and collective effort. Yes, get the feeling of hope. Yes, make the affirmation of hope, but start to move your feet. Perhaps in concert, and again, you're going to get directed. If you're tuned into that divine wisdom, you're going to get directed where to put that. Endurance, character, hope. So back to our story, the gift of the Magi. Well, Della had a $1.87 that she'd saved and scrimped and saved, but that wasn't much to buy a gift for the man she loved. Neither did Jim have a lot to spend on a gift. The best they had, you know, their meager surroundings and a sparse apartment and all of that, was a couple of prized possessions, and each of them had one. Jim had a watch, a beautiful pocket watch, that was owned by his father before him and his grandfather before his father. It was just something that he prized, his prized possession. And Della had hair, beautiful hair. None like it. So on that Christmas Eve, before they joined together when Jim came home from work, Della went out during the day and went to a specialist who took human hair and used it perhaps to make other wigs. And she asked the proprietor, how much for my hair. I want to sell my hair. Thinking, well, maybe Jim won't like me when I don't have my hair. But she wanted so much to give that gift. She was expecting a real celebration around Christmas despite their meager circumstance. $20, said the proprietor. And she said, cut it off. And she took the $20. She went shopping. That beautiful watch that Jim, her husband, had was held together by a worn leather strap held into his pocket. And she found a watch fob chain that was exquisite for $21. $1 from her savings and $20 from the hair that she had sold. Now, on the other side of the thing, Jim went to look for a present. And he found for his wife, knowing how she prized her hair, a beautiful comb set made of tortoise shell. Bejeweled, it was exquisite again. Well, you can tell where this story is going if you didn't know it. They got home, and a little fearful, Della said, it'll grow again, Jim, it'll grow again. And she gave him this beautiful present of the watch fob chain. He was a little somber about it, but then he pulled out his package and handed it to her. And of course it was that comb set made of tortoise shell with jewels. He had sold his watch so that he could give her a gift. It's kind of could be a sad ending to the story, but O. Henry puts it this way. I think, if I'm guessing, Jim and Della had some wonderful celebration that they never would have had if they didn't allow themselves to be bold, to be risky with regard to their giving to each other. O. Henry says, of all who give gifts, these are the wisest. Those who live in hope and expectancy, these are the wisest. Endurance, character, hope. This is a track to living out hope, to knowing the wisdom that is within you. And so it is.
Now it is time to prepare for our meditation. You can turn out the light in person so that we can listen to Karen Drucker's song as we prepare. There is only love.
I remember who I am, letting fear and worry fall away from me. I open my eyes and see there is I've lost my when I go inside and quiet my mind. I can hear spirit gently say, there is only love, there is only love. It's love that heals, love that sets us free. There is only, oh, only love. There is only love. There is only love. Love that heals, love that sets us free. There is only, there is only love. There is only. Love that heals, love that sets me free. There is only, only love. There is only, only love. There is only.
So let us take a moment, actually a couple of minutes, to be in the quiet with the truth that is sitting right before us. So put everything else aside. Make a choice to do that. Just be here in the place where you are right now. Look deep within yourself. So easy to look at things outside, but turn your gaze inward and go deep and remember who you are. When you get to that deep place within, you'll know that you are truly a divine expression. That's who you are. That's your very nature. That's how you were created. And know that that expression that you give out in this world is none other than love. Love from which everything stems. Love that is the inevitable end of the journey, though there is no particular end. Love. It is with expectancy, remembering who we are, love that will let us drop away all worry and all fear. Love that will heal every ill that we have. So take a moment to meditate on who you are, remembering it, and your natural destiny, love. Take a minute in the silence to take this all in. And having taken it in, still as you contemplate, ask the question, this hope, this expectancy that leads me to love, how do I live that out? What is mine to do? Contemplate that in the silence. What you've learned as you've gone within, don't lose track of it. Write it down, rehearse it in your mind. Know that as you take the guidance of spirit, it will bring you to the point that the longing of your heart will be fulfilled. So as we come back to an awareness of this time and place, we bring our awareness back here, knowing that endurance, character building, and positive upward and forward living and pointing hope are ours, leading us to know that we are only love. And so it is.
Thank you, Reverend Neal. Okay, now it is time to share our gifts. Unity of Payson greatly appreciates your gifts in support of this ministry. These gifts also go out to the larger community. As you listen to the offering song, you will have time to make a contribution. If you're here with us virtually, the information for giving is on the slides. You can go to unityofpayson.org and click on the Donate Support tab. We greatly appreciate your gifts. So let's bring our attention to our gift at this time. Let's call to mind our heart's desires. And together, let's affirm. Freely we give, and freely we receive. And our offertory song is The Gathering of Spirits.
Let it go, my love, my truest, let it sail on silver wings. A life's a twinkling, that's for certain, but it's such a fine thing. There's a gathering of spirits, there's a festival of friends, and we'll take up where we left off. We all meet again. I can't explain it, I couldn't if I tried. How the only things we carry are the things we hold inside, like a day in the open. Like the love we won't forget, like the laughter that we started, and it hasn't died down yet. Oh, let it go, my love, my truest, let it sail on silver wings. Life's a twinkling, that's for certain, but it's such a fine thing. There's a gathering of spirits, there's a festival of friends, and we'll take up where we left off when we all meet again. Oh yeah, now didn't we? And don't we make it shine? Aren't we standing in the center of something rare and fine? Some glow like embers, like a light through colored glass. Some give it all in one great flame, throwing kisses as they pass. Oh, let it go, my love, my truest, let it sail on silver wings. Life's a twinkling, that's for certain, but it's such a fine thing. There's a gathering of spirits, there's a festival of friends, and we'll take up where we left off. East of Eden, but there's heaven in our midst, and we're never really all that far from those we love and miss. Wade out in the water, there's a glory all around, and the wisest say there's a thousand ways to kneel and kiss the ground. Oh, let it go, my love, my truest, let it sail on silver wings. Life's a twinkling, that's for certain, but it's such a fine thing. There's a gathering of spirits, there's a festival of friends, and we'll take up where we left off when we all meet again. And we'll take up where we left off when we all meet again.
It's time for the dedication of the offering. So we'll change the slide. Thank you. And we're grateful for these gifts. We're grateful for their abundance. We bless the gifts. We bless the givers. And we say together, can we have the dedication of the offering on the slide, please?
Response, please.
Donna, would you do call and response? Well, if it's not on the slide, we can do call and response. I'll say it first and then say it with me. Divine love flowing through us. Together.
Divine love
flowing through us, blesses and multiplies all that we are together, blesses and multiplies all that we are, all that we have together, all that we have, all that we give and all that we receive together, all that we give and all that we receive. We are abundantly prosperous together. We are abundantly prosperous and together, and we give thanks, and we give thanks. So it is. Amen. That's what this slide said. All right. Next Sunday speaker is Reverend Neal, and we're continuing with our theme of Advent. And his talk title is Peace, the Fruit of Awareness. And I'm going to share a few announcements. We have a potluck after service today, and I bet you're all just waiting for that. We're at 11:07 right now. Sorry to keep you. We have Course in Miracles Tuesday at 6 p.m. Always the first and third Tuesdays, unless there's some other conflict. We have Saturday Soul Boost every Saturday at 4 p.m. on Zoom. Please join us. We have a membership meeting January 7th. Please put that on your calendar. We will have election of officers for the board. Next slide. It's birthday Sunday. It's the first Sunday, so we'll sing happy birthday after we finish the announcements. And there's also another slide for morning coffee. We changed, it's just going to be on Saturdays at 9:30 through December. And so if you like morning coffee, please join us. Put Saturday on your calendar at 9:30. At 9:30, we raised it back to 9:30 because some people are still in bed at 9 o'clock, including your hostess. We have crafts and gifts on the back table. And some of them may have suggested donation prices, but all donations are going to Unity of Payson. And it would be great if we could have a volunteer to man that table after the service, Betty or Sue or somebody who's available. And that would be wonderful. There's also a library back there, and you can check out a book for a whole month. And we have Teresa saying, don't forget Qigong Sunday and Wednesday at 4:30 p.m. on Zoom. And we have put this on your calendar. Friday the 22nd, we're going to have movie night, a Christmas movie, The Family Man with Nicolas Cage. And now we have a PS from Neal.
Well, I don't know that there's anything I can add, but I would just encourage you who are here, there are some marvelous little gifts. Some of them might be stocking stuffers, some of more. They're on a love offering basis, so please be generous with your love offerings, and there's a little box to put it in, and get some Christmas shopping done early.
Reverend Neal, any information about a sing-along?
So we got, well, I'll just say this. We're hatching a sing-along together with the Methodist Church, Christmas carols. You know, we don't often get to sing Christmas carols. And I think it'll probably be on the 16th in the afternoon. We're not gonna go with an evening thing, but an afternoon to just get together and sing some Christmas carols. But stay tuned. So I guess we're at the point where we ask if there are people here who have birthdays in December. Hey, we have one, Sue. You're going to be in the middle of the circle over here. So let's circle up, and then we'll sing Happy Birthday to Sue, followed by the peace song and the prayer for protection. Protection together, the light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. And the presence of God watches over us. I am present wherever we are. God is, and all is well. Thank you so much for being here. Potluck, even if you happen not to remember and bring something, there's going to be plenty, I'm sure. So please join us. And if we can can we get a gallery view, Tom? Oh, I'm not seeing it. Well, I will just say this to all of you who have joined us online. We're so grateful that you're here. And we will see you again very soon. Blessings as you live out hope this week. Okay, then fine.